some restriction along the other side of the country. So I would say the first region now.
Revelation 21, chapter 21, verses 1 to 4. I had already prepared something, so I will read the Revelation first, and then I will read my scripture that I have prepared. Short and sweet, promise. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Right? So, the other scripture is from St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 3. Let not your heart be troubled. He believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there he may also be. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you, God.
Thank you, my God.
I'm going to do it.
Hallelujah. Right, we will take the second reading, which I will be given from Romans 14 to 8. When I rose, this fall of Ghana,
when I rose, this fall of Ghana, when I rose, this fall of Ghana, when I rose, this fall of Ghana, when I rose, excuse to execute that job. She provided us with all the necessary tools to
anointing here every soon. She often has gone for hours, not breathing when I'm off. Ever since I knew myself, she was a God fearing woman. I fought all of her battles on her knees before God. Since I knew myself growing up in Sabbath and Sarah especially, where there were no taxes to dinner on Sundays, my mom would often lead the journey of the Sabbath groups. Walking off of Sabbath and Sarah, not knowing how she's reaching after hours of service, praising God and Sabbath groups. No distance was too far for her to praise the Lord. Well, this had a church to go to attend. I asked them to go to a pilgrimage to attend. The minor details I've shared with you thus far have made me think of the iceberg of a bird inside Philip of a surface individual she was. And then we find ourselves doing so much reflection, and you will see the question ask, why wait till someone has died to honor them and remember them for all that they have done and contributed to our life? Such a question, I honestly do not have an answer. But I am now in the shoes of the one being questioned. And my message to my family, especially, sorry, I don't have much of the youth here today, especially to hear this message, but particularly for them. My message to start with is to do better and to be better. For we are very blessed to have the aunts, uncles, parents, grandparents. And to cherish them for however long we have them again, because they never know when, as we say, they will ring, their time will come. And the reason why I ask my sisters to come up here with me today is because my mom lived a life for us, basically. Nothing that we have done or not done could ever repay her. Now that she is gone, regardless of whatever situation we are in, it's time to put it aside and live for each other.
Amen.
And that's what I want to share with everyone.
Amen. The Lord.
Praise the Lord.
There is no city on earth for me to dwell, my Lord. There is no city on earth. I just want to read one verse of something to you. And I often says, it's a comfort to my heart. Because if you can do it in life, you cannot do it in death. And this is what St. Matthew's Gospel says. Verse 4. And it says, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. And this is what he's asking. Blessed are those that mourn, for they shall be comforted. And this is what God promised. But before I go in to the world, I just want to give a few minutes. Anyone that want to say something? Anyone that want to say something? I'll give it away to you. Your friends, your family. You heard the word from the book of Revelation. You heard the word from the book of Romans. But there's a book of Ephesians that speaks to us also, telling us that there is a time and there is a season for everything that is under the sun. My sister died at home. She was right for the picture. Because God don't pick you when you're green. He don't pick you when you're half right. He pick you when you are right for the picture. A lot of us may say whatever we want to say. But I believe you want to say. My will is what God wants to say. You see, your words are not important. The word that is important today is the word of God, or what God says. And what God is telling us, that there is a time and there is a season for you. When you're born, you come with a dual shot. But how do you believe? Ask yourself how you do. They leave with their two hands wide open. Why? They leave with their hands open. They leave with your hands open because you are begging God for mercy. Amen. It's mercy asking God. You see, when you come holding on to the world. But when they leave, so I wanted to be anyone that can listen to that. I
But we always had a love that we shared even to the end. And this morning, I just want to say, let us love one another. The second greatest commandment of God. He commanded that we love one another and that we love our neighbors as ourselves. You know, that's not how we love ourselves, and we love ourselves. We need to love our neighbors. We need to love one another. We need to hold fast to that which is good. Because it came to me recently that apparently an angel of death is passing. Because I have never heard of so many people dying now. And we, all of us here, have known somebody who died shortly, not from COVID, but died of natural causes. And this morning we need to bind together. We need to circle. Because God is the God of the impossible. There's nothing that he cannot do. And in his word, it says, when the praises go up, the blessings will come down. This morning, I just want us to sing something from this nuclear text. This is a hymn that my sister loves to sing. Whenever there's a thanksgiving, or whenever there's anything, and she is about to sing, you will hear her sing. And in such a sweet one,
to be his
wife.
Get the news and to come to tell with my family that yet still alive. Glory and praise that I can see your face within this region. As my brother said, he said, it happened have been right. So they are picking cane and touch you. But divide on the things they have for him to do, and don't make this the only reunion that you always have to come to this inner room. For it is a reunion, death is a reunion, but this is not the time that we should take a reunion. Because the word of God is so wonderful of the man. So I glad that he has this still around. So I like this fight.
Thank you.
worry about it. One.
Okay, but it's short and sweet. What I would say is that, you know, my mother wasn't free from the last days, you know? And boy, I have no more company again. When I come out in the living room, just I am at home.
Because after we have done all things in our life, if there was a chance, he said, if you have everything in me, come on to me. I will. That's a call he had. Clarence told them, no, come on to me, and I will be here. But today, the first one, the last one, I am just in it. So my biggest sister went, not my last sister, my mother. But God is good. Because he knows what he is doing. You see, he write the book. He know he's the author and the finisher. He know what he is doing. So I cannot question God and ask God why. Because God knows, yes. He's the all-knowing God. And he know why he called him. No more pain. No more sorrow. No more bills to pay. No more bitter water, no more. But she gone to that resting place. I am not going to lie to you and say, I know she gone up to the Father. That is only a talk that they give us to comfort our heart. Because the scripture teaches me that when the trumpet shall sound, it's only then the dead in Christ shall rise. And those that are alive, if we live in a good life, we know we're the reporter to meet him in the sky. So long as my sister has lived a life of faith, and she falls asleep, I know. This is my assurance, Lord. I know she is going to wake again in paradise.
Amen.
In that place that God has promised for us, where there is no night, no day, no more sickness, no more pain, and the street is paved with gold. I know she is going to wake again so long as she has lived her life. But I want to say, I love her. My loving sister. We make choices in our lives. I often say, never regret the choices you make in your life. Always consider the choices you make in your life as stepping stone to strength. Don't regret. Anytime you lived in regret, you will not see the light. But these mistakes are not mistakes. They are lessons to teach you something in life. Amen. My sister has lived about life what she knows. And it's often said, you don't understand. And my brother said, I call him my brother still, because he's my brother. Not that the younger one may not know him, but he grew up in the same yard, the same home. We grew up, everyone used to think we are brothers and sisters. We know we would. And today, our sister is gone. Some may say, and this is something I want to say with you. I don't care what people say, because I don't listen to people. Because if I listen to people, I will not grow. And if they don't bad talk me or don't bad talk you, you will not grow. They stunt your growth. Anytime they're talking about you, your growth stunt. Or they talk about you when you are growing, you are successful in life. They will talk about you because you're moving. When you stop moving, stop talking. But today, I want to tell my family and those that sit here, love is the answer and the key to success in life. Prayer comes first. Pray. Because by prayer we will, and by prayer we will succeed, must succeed. But Jesus said, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess. I, Jesus, Lord, the one answer to your problem, talk to God. You see, a lot of we like to run by friends and by different people to tell them we business and tell ourselves that will help us. I said that will not help you. Run to God. Because when you tell God your business, nobody knows your business but you and God alone. Because anytime you tell yourself you have a friend, your friend or our best friend. And your best friend or my next best friend. So here he goes. And then the message reached to the last best friend. It wasn't the message that made you fool best friend. Because the conversation started to change. And I hate you before I know you. When you enter that life. You know what people didn't see Jesus? But they didn't know about him. Yeah. And they hate him with all that cause. Because he said it. They hate me with all that cause. So they will hate you with all that cause. But you want to be loved. You don't want nobody to hate you. But I want to say how much I love you. You know, because hear what we're going to say today. Why? If it wasn't COVID, this church would have been full if there had been enough people.
Amen.
But I want to ask you today, how much of those people would going to stay with you in the cemetery? Mm. With all the love you, how much of them going to try going down with you? You see, we come alone then. But they don't understand that. We come alone. When we come here, there's only someone with a partner. And your partner is going to leave you sometime. Because here when he walks in, two will be on the mountain top. One will be taken away. Two will be on the bed lying down together. So one will be taken away. Who will leave with? One. Try to understand life. I decide I have no friend. I have acquaintances. I have no friend. You know why I have no friend? Because my friend has an ex friend. So I don't know friend. I don't have acquaintances. I meet you today. Because I love everyone. You see, when you live that kind of life, you don't get in confusion. They can't say, you say. But when you like a friend and you like to tell them your business, you will always be in confusion. End of confusion. If she was in confusion, end of confusion. Don't know what you did. This is me. But this is Jessica Cassier. The important thing going back to the maker. It's going back. You see, this thing that you all take pride in making up is not you. You see, the person you beautify are not you. The minute you can beautify the inner man, which is you, the person, then you're going to be living a good life. But you see, these old filthy rags that we wear, it means nothing to us. Because what goes into the man is not important. But see, what comes out of the man does the defining of the man. So that's why I say, it's the life you live. It's the people you touch while they're living here. You see, all she achieved in her life mean nothing. Because here she ain't have nothing. Look in the box. It has nothing inside there, your mother and the car glass. She about, this carcass about to go from where it's come. From spirit going already. Because it was on the 8th of December, 1999. 1957, the earth opened that place and placed that here with us. And today the earth is about to open again to receive her back into the earth. See, that channel had to open back to put her back in. Understand life and death. Understand it. You see, a lot of us don't care. But I want to tell you, the only thing you can leave behind is your name. The name that you leave behind is important in this journey that we're passing through. It's short, we say it's short. But the only thing is important is your name, saving your name. You could hear what it was saying. See? I take what I'm over. I could have never get that good without that shit. Someone will come along your time and say, oh Lord. When I used to talk to Sister Jenny, the words that she used to give me to give us strength. She remembered the good things that she do. Take a page. In this box today, take a page. Take a page. If you was living and broke your life, take a page. You're going home. See, when you're born, in one hand, you have an arrival ticket. But in this hand, you have a departure ticket. And this departure ticket, you can't see the dates. You can't see the dates of stuff. But you can't see the date, what is already stamped, that you're going back out. Am I preparing to go back out? Or I want to go back out just to not come in. But I want to tell us today that pray that our flight is not in the winter. You know why they said that? Because in the winter the birds can't fly. The ice will hold them down. So they say, pray your flight is not in the winter. Because if your flight is in the winter, sad will be your motion. You can't move. Live a good life. We must try. Because I just confess, I was never a good boy. But God did not come for the righteous. God didn't come. He gave us a chance. But here we say, turn from your wicked ways. He gave me a chance. He said, turn. And I but I would say, I was glad when they said unto me, that let's go into the house of the Lord. So from 70 to now, I am moving. So when somebody said, COVID, I said, I ain't going no way. I stay right there. Because where shall I go now? I told you to turn back. And I want to say to you young ones, it ain't too young. I went in young. From 70 to now, and I'm pressing on. I just say, praise the key to success. I just pray. Or they say, hard. We know what happened. We could eat from the neighbor. Look at me. We could eat from the neighbor. Because if we make joke and we eat from the neighbor when no mother come home, we will get the deal cut. We're hungry, but we have water. We have right thing. We have everything. You say coconut, and we have roast coconut. So we know. So this standard here now, if you can't face it, it's up to you. See, our foundation was properly laid. pray God that these young ones that only know how to buy and not how to do, I am sorry for them. Start to be a portion. Because what you become a receiver. They have nothing to sell. They have nothing to offer. You always want. You always want. You become a dependent. Are you dependent on the government for food? Because of your own plant or your own food. Only are dependent and not independent. And if the government who give all the children, who minister all the lie down and sleep with and give all the children, and give all the money to go in the grocery and give all the hampers or they can't eat or they can't drink, because them give all the children that all they need. He said, the Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord promised to make a way for me. And he will make the same way for me. He said, none of my seed shall break your bread. And I will not spare righteous for Satan. You are not supposed to break your bread when you're serving God. Because I will provide. And if you don't have any more, then you're going to have to leave them. They that trust in the Lord shall be like Mount Zion. Trust in the Lord. You see, you want and you don't want to sacrifice. You want everything the easy way. But here what I tell you, when you want it the easy way, you don't get it the easy way. But there are consequences. Because the law was made for the lawless man. So if you only know bubble and scheme, the poor is going to appear. And that shall be your end. But if you know how to sacrifice, then the Lord will make a way for you. He's the way maker. He is the way maker. I want to tell you, he's not a failing God, but he's a just God. And he's a God that comes just on time. He never late. He never early. But he's a God that comes on time. But you trust him. If all the time you wasn't trusting, must you trust him now? When you look at the body here, try to trust God. Because you're going. Today is your day. What day is yours? I'm afraid of them because I'm dependent. Here we say, you know, this morning I get up about 3 o'clock. Couldn't go back to sleep. But I still reach down here just on time. You know what I say? I got 3 o'clock. I couldn't sleep. Something wake up. I'm going to tell you, I don't want to wake up just for that now. And when it wake up, I couldn't go back. So I start to do everything. I then shoot, I so that way. Because I shoot, I am. I know I am these before. I said, no for now. I am shooting. I go back here. I go out here. I go to. That of it. And I still reach just one night. I do it. I say that there is a money. And I trust God. I will be here on time. You see, Christian, God guides your way. Anytime you get up in the morning and you don't feel to go, don't go in. You change your clothes and everything and your mindset, don't go to him. Don't go in. But when something happens, wait a second. Oh, oh. I should have followed the man. He gave us a strong mind. God didn't give us a mind of faith. So to be Christians, we are the Lord. We are the Lord. Just God. You know, I have a little storm. I hear you listen. Abide with me. Pass forth the evening time. The darkness deeper. And Lord with me abide. The Lord with me abide. Can God abide with sister here? Can God abide with sister here? No, he can't abide with you today. It's me and you know he has to abide with. Because some of us are doing praying, we still been on the wrong things. So you have to abide with us.
Thank you. guys know what site to go on, and I'll call you guys.
Just close off the stream, man. Eh?